Good morning, church. It is good to be with you all this morning on this Pet Blessing Sunday. And we hear all the children of God rejoicing, right? We're all here to worship even our pets, and they are here to sing loudly with us. We're so glad that each of you is here, and all of you joining us online, maybe your pets are next to you as well, and know that all of you are a special part of our community. We're glad that you're with us today. Friends, this week has been a week for many of us, and there are people in our world who are deeply afraid of what might ensue over the next 4 years. And know that your feelings are safe here in this place. That this place has always been a place for all people. And St. John's on the Lake United Methodist Church will continue that work. We will continue being a sanctuary for all people. And we will continue fighting for a world where love is the norm and where love is the only standard in which we treat one another. So know that, friends, you are welcome here this morning, whatever you're feeling and holding in this place. And I pray that every one of us might feel the presence of God as we worship, as we come to bless our pets, as we sing together in this place. Friends, let us open with a word of prayer as we begin today. Holy and gracious God, we give you thanks. On the hard days, we give you thanks for your presence that refuses to leave us or forsake us. And today, we are reminded of your presence by the people here in this room, by the pets who are singing loudly already, and our families and friends all over who have walked this journey with us. So God, as we come into this place, we lift our hearts to you and ask that your spirit might lift our spirits as we sing and as we come together. We offer you this time in worship. Amen. Well, friends, let us stand and sing our opening hymn, Morning Has Broken. Let us join our voices together. Would you all remain standing as you join in our call to worship this morning? You'll find the words on the screens above or in your bulletin. God of infinite and marvelous love, you created each of us in your image. In the vastness of your creativity, you made us in unique and diverse ways. Today, help us embrace one another. We are creatures of your love. As we bless and honor our pets, remind us to be stewards of love. As we gather here and out in the world, nurture us in the presence of love. Amen. Each week we affirm who we are as a community, and today I pray that we might say these words boldly and loudly together as we will commit ourselves to this work today and every day on end. Friends, let us affirm who we are. St. John's on the Lake is a reconciling congregation that affirms the sacred worth of all people. All are welcome to fully participate in the life of our church and ministries, each of us as we grow with God and in our faith. Whatever your race, ethnicity, economic situation, gender or sexual orientation, background, or God-given abilities, you are welcome here. God calls us to acts of love, grace, and advocacy, together here and out in the world. We hope to be a sanctuary and a place without barriers for all of God's creation. Amen. You all may be seated. We have some friends who are eager to play together. Yes, as we enter into this time, I do want to take a brief moment and share some announcements with you, as this is a very busy season that we are in as a church, very exciting season. But lots of things coming up that I want you to be aware of. Next Sunday, thank you, Duke. He's excited about all the things happening. Next Sunday is our next Big Gay Brunch Church, and the theme will be belonging. And in light of the election this past week, we want to dedicate the Big Gay Brunch Church to be a place for people to come and belong, to have conversations, to be supported, and to be loved. And so if you're available, Big Gay Brunch Church next week will be actually at 1 p.m. instead of 2 p.m. We had success last month at moving it up to 1 p.m., and so we're gonna move in that trajectory for now and see how it goes. So Big Gay Brunch Church next Sunday at 1 p.m. The following Sunday, November 24th, we will be decorating the church for Christmas. Can you believe it? I've already decorated my house for Christmas, so I'm ahead. But 2 weeks from today, we'll be decorating the church. So please, if you are able, come and lend a hand. It won't take too long, but we do need to put up our big Christmas trees, decorate the sanctuary in preparation for the 100th anniversary on December 8th. Super exciting things happening. We have some previous pastors coming, our bishop, our district superintendent, my parents. Many of you and your loved ones will be here, and I hope you will invite others and join us for that special occasion. And then also November 24th, 2 weeks from today, we'll be having a kayak chapel. We're praying for that because we've had some bad luck with storms and rain every kayak chapel we've had, but we're going to shoot for November 24th as well. Those are all the announcements I will lift up this morning in lieu of our animals that are ready to get on with worship. So I'm going to invite up Jenny to read our scripture this morning as it comes from the Old Testament.
Good morning, church, and good morning, puppies. The reading this morning is Genesis chapter 1, verses 20 through 25. And God said, "Let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky." So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves of every kind with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let birds multiply on the earth." And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of the earth of every kind." And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Thank you, Jenny. Friends, would you all pray with me as I begin this morning? Great and holy God, be with us in these days and this moment as we come to worship, as we seek the comfort, the inspiration of your Spirit. Lord, speak to me, through me, beyond me, in spite of me, if necessary, that your word might be proclaimed in this space. Amen. Well, friends, today is a very special day. Not only is it our Pet Blessing Sunday, but some of you know that today marks exactly 1 year since I adopted this pretty boy right here. Yes, it's Rocket's gotcha day, and he sees some boys he wants to play with. But this day is incredibly special because my life has changed exponentially in the last year. When they say that when you rescue a dog, dogs actually rescue you. And I can attest to the fact that this is true. My life is not the same as it was a year ago. Just the other day, I texted my mom to let her know that it had been a whole year since I was looking at dogs on shelter websites, and I had a screenshot of Rocket's picture that I texted to my mom. I said, "Can you believe it's been a whole year?" And when I thought about it, it feels like I've had this dog for so much longer than a year, because that's how much my life has just become all about him. It's hard to remember a life without him, except for one thing, and that's a house without dog hair. I do remember that. Thank you. We're excited that you're in worship, too. All of you who know me know that this dog has become my everything. Since I do not have a partner, I don't have children, this is my family, and this is my child, and it's an honor to share him with you all and to be able to offer this service where we get to bless him and all of your furry friends with us today. It is a gift and a blessing to have creatures like this in our lives, to be nurtured by them. And I really don't believe this service could be any better timed than this week. In the midst of the unimaginable, in the midst of the heaviest days, pets have a way of comforting us. They have a way of grounding us. And I would go as far as to say that they have a way of healing us. Pets embody love. They have a way of bridging divides that people cannot do. And if you don't believe me, go to the park with this dog right here. He'll meet every single person that we walk by, no matter what they look like, no matter how they act, how they speak. Rocket will befriend them. Pets have a way of crossing barriers, of bringing about love into the world. So for any of you today that are feeling heavy, that are feeling a bit discouraged, afraid, terrified, grieving for many reasons, please soak in the love of the animals that are here. If you don't have an animal, I will lend you Rocket. He will love to love you. He loves to love. And all of you pet owners who are in this place, I encourage you to cherish this moment. Cherish the moments that we have with our dogs, with our cats, our animals of every kind, because our pets are what hold us, what love us in the really hard moments. We have some really eager pets in the back. Oh, it's so cute. Friends, these are the sounds of God's creatures. This is why we don't do pet blessings every Sunday, but we do it once a year because we can bear the sounds, because friends, just like animals make sounds of every kind, people make sounds of every kind, and we welcome that. We welcome all emotions, all creatures, and know that you are loved. So Jenny read for us moments ago a scripture from Genesis, which reminds us that from the very beginning of creation, animals have always been there. God created animals, and God called them good. Just like God calls us good, God calls animals good. They exist to remind us of the vast diversity of God's love that is so unique in every creature. Every creature that we look at embodies love in a very unique way, and pets are a true representation of that love among us. So if you do not have a pet and you're here today, I urge you to get one. Daryl's shaking his head no. You don't want to hear the dog, the barking all the time? You know, there's some people in this room. Lori, hey, whoa, Rocket never barks. Lori encouraged me for a very long time to get a dog, and I've wanted a dog. I've been without a dog since I was a kid, or since I graduated from my parents' home. And I have loved dogs, but I never... Excuse you. Sit. Rocket, sit, buddy. I was a little hesitant to get a dog, and I finally bit the bullet, and I rescued this dog a year ago, and friends, I have to tell you, I will never look back. Because in this last year, on the hardest days, this dog has been here to comfort me, to offer a loving presence, to offer some fun noise. This dog has been with me through it all. But friends, I have to tell you, I know all of you love your dogs, but only I can have the most beautiful and the best dog in the world. That's why Rocket gets to be up front. No, but truly, friends, all of your animals are beautiful images of God's love, and they embody love in a very powerful way. And they are special creatures that God has blessed us with. And it's a gift to hold them, to play with them, to cuddle them, to be nurtured by them. The one thing I've learned in the last year is something about unconditional love. I've had some pretty hard days in the last year, and I can be in the worst mood and not want anything to do with people or the dog, and guess what? Rocket makes it happen. He has a way of forcing himself onto you. He thinks he's a lap dog, and he will force his way into your life, whether you like it or not, but he will force it in a way that is so loving and so just beautiful, right? I can be in a bad mood, and he has a way of cheering me up. And it can be the most boring day in the world, and he makes it the most adventureful, right? The most adventurous day, because he always does something new and different. And I think animals keep us on our toes. You never know what they're going to do. You never know how they're going to surprise us. So, in all of that, pets embody unconditional love. And in this past week, every single day at my home, I have looked in the eyes of this dog because he loves to make eye contact. And I have been reminded that though I live, I'm the only human in my household, I'm not alone. And friends, that is the message for each of us today, that you are not alone, that we are not alone. God has made every single one of us. God calls us God's very own. God calls us good. And God longs for a place where we can belong among one another, where we can embody love to and for one another. And who better to teach us than our pets? Our pets can teach us how to forgive. Our pets can teach us how to move on. And our pets can remind us that every single day we can come back to love over and over and over again. It is a love that will never leave nor forsake us. So friends, today might we be forever grateful for the pets that remind us in the very challenging, most discouraging moments that God's love is among us. Let us rejoice and be grateful for God's love. Amen. At this time, I will invite our ushers to come forward and receive our gifts today. Let us give from our hearts, knowing that this work, the work of our church, the ministry of our church, will be to make a safe space for all people to come and belong together. Let us give back to our God. Friends, let us stand to give thanks to God for the gifts and the creatures in our midst as we sing our doxology together. Let us pray. Great God, we give you thanks for the gifts that have been offered in this place, for the people who have offered them, for the love that has been given in them. Lord, would you take it all, multiply it, and use it to bring about your kingdom of love here on earth as it is in heaven. Amen. You all may be seated. At this time in our service, we come to the part where we've all been longing for, to come and to bless our pets. And at this time, I'm going to come and bring Rocket to one of these people up here. Thank you. Rocket, stay. He's very attached to me, so this is going to be a challenge. So, friends, we come today and offer this special service because pets are a part of us. They're part of our families. They're part of our stories. They're a gift from God. And so today is an opportunity to recognize our interdependence on them. As much as they depend on us, we depend on them. And so today we come to bless those that love us, that care for us, and that walk with us. We know that the animals of God's creation inhabit the skies, the earth, and the sea. They share in the fortunes of human existence and have a part in our human life. God bestows gifts on all living things and has often used the presence of animals and made them the most visible reminders of unconditional love. All created beings are beloved creatures of divine love, and it is our role as humans to nurture, grow, and protect all beloved creatures that are within our care and reach. And so today we come and invoke God's blessing on all living animals, especially those in this room. And as we do so, let us give thanks to God, who has created them all and invites us to be stewards of God's love in them. So at this moment, we're going to have two different prayers. I'll offer one general blessing for all of our pets that are in this room and those of you who have pets that are not here, that are still at home. Those of you watching online will also offer a second prayer, which is a prayer for the pets that we have loved and that we have lost, the pets that remain a part of us. And then after that prayer, we'll invite everybody to come forward to receive individual blessings today. So hear this prayer called Blessing the Animals by Jan Richardson as we begin this time. This is a general blessing for all of our animals near and far. Let us pray. O Divine One, you who created them and called them good, bless again these creatures who come to us as a blessing fashioned of fur or feather or fin, formed of flesh that breathes within your own breath that you have made, from sheer delight that you have given in dazzling variety. Bless them who curl themselves around our hearts, who twine themselves through our days, who companion us in our labor, who call us to come and play. Bless them who will never be entirely tamed, and so remind us that you love what is wild, that you rejoice in what lives close to the earth, that your heart beats in the heart of these creatures that you have entrusted to our care. Amen. Let us also remember the pets that are no longer physically with us, but are always here with us. Let us pray. Holy One, we give thanks for the gift of all of our pet friends, those with us now, but especially those we hold in our hearts that have gone on before us. We give thanks for the cherished memories we hold, the ways our lives have been enriched by these creatures. When our hearts hurt, may your ultimate love tend to our wounds and bring us healing. And may the love we have shared with our pets continue to abide within us and radiate joy in our lives. Amen. Amen. Well, at this time, we will invite you to form an individual line, and I will take each family unit and bless your pets as one family at a time. And then if you'll make your way back to your seat, and we'll have our closing part of the service following this. Yes. Come forward and receive this blessing today. Amen, amen. Friends, in this moment, we will have a brief moment of prayer. In this moment will be more of a moment of silence or loudness with our animals, for us to offer our prayers and concerns to God, who hears us and holds us in all moments of life. Our choir will sing over us, and then we will just have a moment of silence for you to pray. And in this time, know that our crises candles hold space for us and the many crises of our lives. And we are held together by the light of Christ that is always among us. Let us take this time and pray together. Surely, Lord, you are among us. And these animals and their sounds remind us that you are always here. Even when we want to believe that you have left us, we know that you are here. So, God, today remind us over and over and over again that your love is in us, around us, and everywhere we look. Might we pay attention to it, might we see it, might we honor it, might we cultivate it and share it wherever we go. Might we be stewards of your love now and always. Lord, make us to be your disciples. As we pray how you taught your disciples long ago, saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, we will close our service with a song that each of us knows and could probably sing by heart, a song, Lean on Me. So this day, this hour, might we lean on each other, might we lean on the pets that are surrounding us, and know that love is always, always, always among us. Let us sing together. Thank you, choir. Thank you, music team, for reminding us that we can lean on one another each and every day that we are given on this earth. We have one another. Friends, hear this poem by Mary Oliver as we close today. If you all know, Mary Oliver is an incredible poet, was an incredible poet, and loved animals. And so she wrote this poem called Little Dog's Rhapsody in the Night. Hear these words. He puts his cheek against mine and makes small expressive sounds. And when I'm awake or awake enough, he turns upside down his four paws in the air and his eyes dark and fervent. Tell me you love me, he says. Tell me again. Could there be a sweeter arrangement? Over and over, he gets to ask. I get to tell. Friends, we get to tell the story of love over and over again. Let us return to love each and every day of our lives. Go in the great love of God, our Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Amen. As you close today, for all of you pet lovers, there are pet treats on the back table. Please take some. There's some for puppies and for dogs. I put the bags in front of the bowl so you can see which ones are which. There's a cat treat thing, Miss Edie's back there as well. And then there's some dog treats for everyone as well. Please take, enjoy, let us be merry, and soak in the love of our pets today.